How do you practice to get results? So it's a hard passage, and it's played again and again and again and again for 20 times. In a good scenario, the person starts slow and speeds up. But most of the times, that's not what has happened. It's just they will learn it by repetition of this exact same thing. And guess what? On the 20th time, it sounds exactly the same. Maybe one note was faulty and now not. It was mindless. Because I practiced like this for years, for decades. All of a sudden, through the Feldenkrais, I said, what do you want? What are you clear about? What do you want to change? And are you thinking about how to change it? You have to do something different. If you do the same thing again and again, expecting different outcomes, it's a definition of insanity, right? That's how it sounded. So here comes, how do you practice to get results, right? So first of all, you come, as you say, with a preconceived idea about how those pieces should sound. Right? And you try to get that. I would say, well, which performance is it that you're trying to imitate? What does it mean to be perfect? There is no such thing, otherwise we wouldn't say that. Like the word ideal, right? Who decides that it's perfect? The notes have to be there. Some people think that if you play fast, that's perfect. Right? So the whole notion that there is perfection, that is a, look, I've thought about it a lot because it's a problem of classical music, which was not a problem in jazz. And I like to talk about improvisation because even in jazz, Feldenkrais can help, right? But at least they start actually, most, not all, but as young people without music, just by hearing jazz and loving it and then starting to improvise. Right? And what is perfect? They're great people, but they're five great people playing very differently. So first of all, this whole thing that there's something perfect in classical music and that you have to be able to do that comes from an idea of imitation.